To make life easy, Illustrator works via the driver and I don't want to go to my driver setup every time. So I will make life easy and I will install the driver three times. I will first of all take this one, manage, printing preferences. No, sorry, that's actually printer properties I need. And this will be my color printer, which of course, oh, sorry, I have to go back since the name changed. Color printer, which of course I will set to print in color, and to gain some speed now, rotate 180, printing to the layer editor. It's funny, if you rename it, it loses all the settings it has. So rotate, fine printing, normal, but I will switch to large. Not that I have any curved objects, but I just want to give my computer a bit more breathing room for its processor while my video software records all of this. And of course, not to forget data width. Yes, this all seems to be okay. That's my color printer layer editor. Right, let's close this and let's go back to the software and install the driver once more. Add a new printer. Next, I agree. Next, network. And I have to use the same address. They will print to the layer editor anyway. Printer name. This will be the one I use for white. Finish. And I will install a third printer, which will be used for varnish. Double click on driver installation. New one. Agree. Next. Same address. And this one will be used for varnish printing. Finish. So after installing my driver three times, I had a bit of a surprise. It appears that Windows 10 shows only one driver. Luckily, all three are installed. In reality, he just groups the same drivers. As you can see, all three are available. And it's important that we change the preferences of every one of them. So we have to print to the layer editor. That's common for all drivers. The portrait mode, to rotate. It's also important to use the same print mode. You cannot mix print modes as long as you are going in the single table printing method. What might, however, be important could be the enable gradation. This is for varnish and white, the difference between all or nothing and the difference between following an image density. So if I uncheck this box, there will be varnish wherever I place a pixel. If I check the box, the varnish will follow the density, the darkness of my image. My image will be transformed to grayscale, and the darker it is, the more varnish we have. For varnish, not so much of use, but especially for white ink, in case you want a white gradient, check this box. For the moment, I'm gonna keep on working like this, because this also consumes a bit more processing power. So all my drivers are set. And now I can use the benefit of Illustrator, the designing possibilities. That is to say, if you have a design which is made in layers, then you can switch on and switch off whatever you like. So I will print, let's say, don't need the editable text, no, the outlined text. We will print everything in color. So I go Windows P. Sorry, that's the wrong button. Control P for printing. I choose my color driver. No need for rotation. And the benefit on Illustrator is that you have a positioning. Actually, it's the best in that. Photoshop doesn't do it that good, and Acrobat Reader, the free version, doesn't do it at all. At least in Illustrator, I have some positioning. Keep in mind that this small preview is always in portraits. If you have a 461, it will also be in portrait, and your lower right corner will be here. You will have to turn your head sideways to view the image, actually. But if you know that, then it's possible to work with it, of course. This is my color. I print this one. And what will we do for white or varnish ink? Let's say I just want to have my text a bit structured, so I will switch off whatever else, the stamp as well. All these things I would like to have in structuring. So I do file, print, and we print this to the varnish machine. Print. And now it's a matter of waiting. So the driver is preparing the documents. Now it's a matter of waiting until they arrive in my layer editor where I can assemble them. Let's choose print mode. I want to have a reasonable thick layer of varnish so the multi-layer can repeat. But actually, it's possible to double the ink and single layer as well. Not going to go too deep in there. In the manual, it's described with the multi-scan, multi-strike actually. For the moment, I want to have glossy varnish on color. And it's a matter of waiting now. So here we go. We have the two files. I double-click them and we print them. So here we are, my print from Illustrator, two layers. So with Illustrator, of course, I have the benefit I can use vector images, PDF and layers, for example, and have a great result thanks to the glossy varnish. Right, ready to post this card.